Hello everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we are going to do the carving of maxillary second premolar. So let's start it. First of all, mark 0.85 cm square on all the four sides of the block. Then mark 1.4 cm another square on all the four sides of the block. Then mark the central line on all the four sides of the block and also on the upper surface of the block. Then mark the sides such as labial, lingual, mesial and distal on all the four sides. Then mark 5 mm on the cervical line on the labial and lingual sides. Also mark 7 mm on the incisal edge on the labial and the lingual sides. Then join the points such that a trapezoidal shape is formed. Then start removing the wax from the either sides of the trapezoid. So now we will divide the labial and lingual surface into three equal parts. After this, we will start marking the mesial and the distal slopes. The mesial slope is shorter and the distal slope is longer, exactly opposite to what we have seen in the maxillary first premolar. So make it carefully. Remove the wax properly such that we can see here a shape of a pentagon. So now mark the central line and also mark two lines beside it where we are going to form our cusp. So now we will start removing the wax from the labial and the lingual sides. At the cervical third area, we have to keep a bulge which will form our height of contour, and we will start removing the wax from the upper surface. We can see here that the central ridge is almost negligible or not present, so we are not going to make it. We will make the surfaces smooth and rounded. After this, we will do the markings for the triangular fossas on the mesial and the distal sides near the margins. We will draw two small triangles. After this, we will mark the central ridges inside and we will start removing the wax from the either sides of the ridges, such that the slopes will be formed. The slopes should meet the triangular fossas. You can see here in the figure. So while making a triangular fossa, we have to keep in mind that the mesial and distal marginal ridges are prominent. So carefully remove the wax from a little ahead. Try to make a triangular pit, which will be our triangular fossa. Remove the wax from the fossa with the help of the carver and clean the surface. It will be looking like this. The cusp tips are not so sharp as we have seen in the maxillary first premolar. So we will make it blunt. Also the edges are smooth and rounded, so make them. So we can see here that the crown is almost ready. So we can make out here all the surfaces and the triangular fossa. So now we will start with the root. So first of all, we will draw the root on the labial and lingual side. It is tapering, and we will start removing the wax from the mesial and the distal sides. So similarly, on the mesial and distal sides, we will draw the root and start removing the wax from the labial and lingual sides. The shape of the root is little bit bulky from mesial and distal sides, so make it carefully. Also clear the edges, make them round and smooth. After this, we will make the depression on the mesial and the distal sides on the root. With the help of back side of the carver, we will make it. After this, we will start marking the cervical line on all the four sides of the crown. To make it carefully, so now clean the wax with the help of the cotton, or simply give a soap water wash. So this was the video on maxillary second premolar. Hope this video helps you. So like the video and subscribe the channel so you can see my other videos and get notifications. Thank you.